бордюр. Царский флот шел в осажденный Порт-Артур. Дерзкий план и долгий путь, но с нами Бог. Гордо реет флаг вблизи японских берегов. К чьим ногам падет Китай, рассудит бой. Император Мэйти или же царь Николай II. 220 дней в морях, путь опасен и жесток. Курс ведет от Балтики эскадру на Владивосток. Я не человек, стоянный сердце вселенца. Словно нет океана, врага протекая кран. Проливать морей, рассекать на всех парах. Обреченный на смерть, последний флот императора. Наугад во тьме, ведомые судьбой. План раскрыт, враг поджидал, был принят бой. 37 против 125. Нас ждет смерть, но нет обратного пути. Исход битвы предрешен, в цепких лапах западни. Плотный шквал снарядов клочья разрывал листы брони. Волны бились об огонь, цепь флотилии шла под нож. Берега Цусимы окропил с небес кровавый дождь. Я не человек, стоянный сердце вселенца. Словно гнев океана, врага притекая кран. Бронить лади морей, рассекать на всех парах. Обреченный на смерть, последний флот императора. Стальной клинок слух отдаст сигнальный взмах. Железный флот империй двух схлестнув в морских боях. Стая несется, вселяя страх. Словно гнев океана, врага притекая кран. Бронить лади морей, рассекать на всех парах. Обреченный на смерть, последний флот императора. Несется вселяя страх. Словно гнев океана, врага притекая кран. Бронить лади морей, рассекать на всех парах. Обреченный на смерть, последний флот императора.
Okay, hello everybody. I know we're about 2 minutes short of 3:30, but I feel like I'm going to go ahead and start the pre-show just a little bit early. Hi there. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever time of day it is, sorry. I hope it's a great one. I'm That Cash Guy, I'm your host, and welcome again if you're coming back from last week's, or yesterday's game, sorry, not last week's. Welcome back, and if you're new, welcome to the second game of the first week of the Starverse Football League. I'm That Cash Guy, your host, of course, like I just said, and today's game, if you missed yesterday's, the VOD is available up on the Twitch stream. It is also up on the YouTube channel, same name, That Cash Guy. It is up there as well. It was a great game between the Carolina Reapers and the Iowa Dark Magicians, in which Carolina got the victory 27-20. It was one heck of a competitive game all the way to the very end. And in the end, it was Carolina making their debut with Aaron Bailey on his brand new team getting the victory. But today's game is a whole lot different story. We got another debuting team from the expansion, the Stanford Superstars. And yes, I know what you're thinking. Stanford. Are you thinking Stanford, Connecticut? Yes. This is because this team is completely inspired off of the fact that if Tony Khan and his father can own the Jacksonville Jaguars, then there's no way in hell that Shane McMahon and Vince McMahon should own a football team and a simulation company. The Stanford Superstars, the Big Eagle and the Superstar, the Golden Black, they have a phenomenal team set up from the expansion draft. They picked up, of course, like I said, every expansion team, all three teams, picked up one player from each of the five existing teams from last season and added them to their rosters. So they picked up five incredible players. One of the players they picked up from the Florida Flamingos, in fact, is going to be playing here tonight, and I think he's actually a starter, if I can go ahead and get a look. And I think it is. It is indeed, if I can go ahead and find him. Yes, they did. They picked up a, the backup quarterback, actually. The former backup quarterback for the Florida Flamingos, Brian Mann. And they actually picked him up. But the biggest name that they acquired in the expansion draft was actually Masako Watanabe, another former Iowa Dark Magician who is a defensive back, and they will be playing linebacker this season. They switched over from defensive back to linebacker at the discretion and the request of the Stanford Superstars, and they have gotten approved of that. So Watanabe will be going from being a safety to a linebacker, which really isn't that much of a difference considering that Watanabe played linebacker most of the season last season while part of the team was either out injured or playing different positions due to the lack of having a complete roster at the time. Of course, the limitations of that video game, of course, are playing into that. Of course, this is the Access era, so everything will be done on Access football now. So this is going to be a whole lot different. They both have full 52-man teams. They're playing on 100-yard fields. Last night or yesterday, during the pre-show, we spoke to Max Stiles, the quarterback of the Iowa Dark Magicians. He said it was really tough losing Aaron Bailey. It was tough losing Watanabe. And will it be tough to watch for him again to see him probably succeed on the Superstars? But that's if they get past this very tough and formidable Florida Flamingos team. The Florida Flamingos, of course, are rebranded, and this is one of the biggest stories also going into the season. They were formerly known last season as the Baton Rouge Water Boys, and they were a really big fan favorite. Matter of fact, they were so unexpected of a fan favorite that they ended up actually making it to first place the majority of the season last season, and actually going only losing two games before, of course, falling short and then losing in the first round of the playoffs to the Manhattan Thieves. So they're looking for a little bit of redemption. They've been rebranded into the Florida Flamingos. That gives us two Florida-based teams in the SFL, which is a bit controversial because they both use the same arena, but it's fine. It is what it is. You know, fan bases are always going to be split like that. It's like the 49ers and 49ers and Raiders situation a little bit. The Flamingos also have another big story. Former quarterback Jordan Nicholson. Yes, I'm saying former. That's not, don't worry, he's still on the team, but he is no longer playing quarterback. He has requested to switch from quarterback to tight end, which is a really big, big call. He's taking the Tim Tebow strategy here. Nicholson, who was arguably one of the best quarterbacks in the season last season, has chosen not to play quarterback this season. The reason being is because they recently drafted a quarterback in Antonio Stark, who appears to be extremely ready to man the helms. He's been named the offensive captain for this team as well. So the team captain and the offensive captain will be playing together. We've seen how tight ends really work in this last game when Liam Action and Keith Ryan both had phenomenal showings in the game yesterday between Carolina and Iowa. More specifically, in Keith Ryan's favor, Keith Ryan made five catches. With five times he was targeted. He made seven catches and got several first down attempts. I believe he even got almost in the triple digits for yardage. Liam Action, on the other hand, he did phenomenal. He got a couple first down conversions. He wasn't the outstanding player of Carolina in that victory, but he's definitely one of those people that attributed to their win. When you talk about everybody that is on the Flamingos side as well, you don't want to forget defensive tackle Michael Carter. Michael Carter is a monster out there. He is one of the biggest and scariest defensive linemen that we have seen out to date. He is 6'6". He weighs 375 pounds, and he is a sack machine. He has sacked every single quarterback that played for the four teams, with the exception of Nicholson, on the Starburst Football League last week. He recorded 8 sacks at average. He recorded a sack every single game that he played. And who knows if that will be the case here. Word is it that Stanford has a very strong offensive line. We'll be able to see that in play today. We'll also be able to see how the other new members of the Stanford Superstars are going. One person I do not want to also forget is the recently brought over Casey Quest Wilson. And Quest is a phenomenal player. Quest is a great player. He didn't really have the best showing playing for the Titletown Red Lions last season, but he made some season-making and playoff-saving interceptions, and he's actually going to be playing wide receiver this season rather than playing his usual defensive side. He's done both. He's also been a kick returner. That'll be a big interesting deal to see what they do with Wilson here. They also have two young running backs in Toby Coleman, and I believe the other running back's name is Tyshawn Dawkins. They're both two very young rookie running backs. We'll be able to see them. They'll be going up against a very tough running back squad on Florida's side. They have Matt Gray and Kwazi Mbutabe as the fullback and running back, respectively, for those teams. And Mbutabe is known as being a very passionate human being about his culture and about the way he plays. He is a dangerous individual. Talk about dangerous individuals. Matt Gray is no one to sneeze at. The man has been nicknamed the Samsung refrigerator. He's big, he's white, he's fast, and he's scary, and he's got a cold demeanor about him. And of course, you want to talk about the all-core receiving unit by Florida. Not only do they have the newly added Amon Drake, who came in mid-season last year to take over for somebody, they still have Darren Chiaverini coming in as their usual fourth slot. They have Lawrence Nightingale. Lawrence Nightingale the eighth, who has been like a sleeper wide receiver this season. It's phenomenal to see how well they do in this type of environment. They're a very small individual, but man, they really use that size difference to their advantage. They sneak between receivers. He catches the ball. He gets touchdowns. And then you got David Fowler. I will not forget about David Fowler, and I don't think any of you will either if you've never seen him before. Fowler, of course, is the usual kick returner for the Flamingos, former Waterboys. Fowler recorded the most kick returns for touchdowns last season. He is a very, very sly individual. He's got really long reach. He's got a great jumping distance, and he's got one hell of a speed cap on him. Folks, I'm telling you that this is going to be one heck of a game between these two teams. And of course, if you're enjoying, if you enjoy this game when it happens, or if you want to see the other two games that are going to happen tomorrow and Monday at the same time, respectively, you can go ahead and hit a follow on this YouTube channel, on this Twitch channel. You can go to the YouTube channel and hit a subscribe. It's the same name as the Twitch, and you will know when we go live with these SFL games. We are about 20 minutes away almost from kickoff. So let's talk about a little bit more on the defensive side for both of these teams. I want to talk about the linebacker core. I want to talk about the strong linebacker core of the Stanford Superstars. Of course, I brought up Masako Watanabe, the defensive captain, who's over on linebacker now. They also have Tariq Van Diver. They have Jax Nixon, who was on the backup. They have Ted Lawless, who is a big, big, big veteran. And he is known for getting some big hits and big plays that matter. He's almost like Teddy Bruschi out there. Meanwhile, over on Florida's side, you want to talk about mean linebackers. Let me name these three, and you tell me if this is mean enough. Johnny Farmer, Baron Corbin, and Bill Goldberg. You heard that right. Bill Goldberg. That is their starters. Their backups, Clarence Lawson, Chuck Reed, James Mendoza. That is an all-star team. You couldn't shuffle this one any better. They both have young men over on the defensive backside, however. So a lot of inexperienced safeties coming into this battle. And then, of course, you got Mike Magnum Maxwell, who's coming in as the kicker for the Flamingos. He's been a great team. He's been a great player on either team he's played on. He's played on three different teams. This is his second year with his third team. This will be the first time he's ever been on a team longer than a year. And it's actually great to see him coming into his own as a kicker. Meanwhile, on the kicking side for Stanford, you're going to be seeing the debut of Fred Stout. Fred Stout is a young prospect. He's got one heck of a foot on him as well. As well, you're going to be talking about Joe Peoples, Javarian Washington, Chris White, Kerry White. Chris Willis, Carl Tirpitz, AC Tatum. These are all names you're going to have to look out for. Another name you're going to look out for. I'm sorry to bring him back to the receiving core. I have ADHD almost. It's like Chris Knight and OC Gray. You're going to want to look out for those two players as well as the second and third string receivers for the superstars if they get utilized today. You're going to want to also look out for Quincy Kisler, the brother of Keontae Kisler. We saw Keontae Kisler play yesterday and playing for the Reapers, and he did great on that team. So we're going to have to look out for Quincy. Ladies and gentlemen, this game starts in about less than 20 minutes. We're going to hit another quick music break, and then when we come back, it'll be 10 minutes from kickoff, and we'll be going down the official experts' opinions from the Access panel about who they think is going to win this battle. So do not go anywhere. Do not adjust your sets. Get comfortable. We'll be right back in 10 minutes.
I won't be going anywhere. I will guard this post forever. Here on the alpine slope, where I did my final stand, I shall remain among the ice and snow that binds me to this mountain. A force of nature too strong, sent from above, where spirits lead the way, the winds will never fade. White Friday, I'll take the stairway to heaven. I'm sky high, when I die, I'll be immortal. Forever, I never, I won't return to Blood Mountain. I am the soldier of heaven. I watched the soldiers come and go, and I kept my watch forever. So many brave men fell in the battles that were raging down below. I have seen it all, but none will hear my story. All of these years I have been frozen in time. I cried for spring to come, but here winter remains. White Friday, I'll take the stairway to heaven. I'm sky high, when I die, I'll be immortal. Forever, I never, I won't return to Blood Mountain. I am the soldier of heaven.
sessions and bicycle messengers, punks and high school dropouts. I ran into this guy I knew, hadn't seen in years. We went into the neon kitchen, stole a couple beers. Said his girl had dumped him, but was there with another guy. Said that he still liked her. All I could say was, all I could say was, all I could say was, why, oh, why, oh, why is it always like this? Either you're too mean or you're too nice. Said I even cooked a breakfast. Someone was blasting Zeppelin. Sounded good, I felt ashamed. I knew every.
going to have to go up against. However, they fell up just a little bit short, but they did not go down without a fight. Meanwhile, on the opposite side, you're taking a look at the Stanford Superstars, a team completely built from the ground up with just a few people borrowed from a few teams, from a couple teams that are really leading the core, going up against a very, very well-prepared, very fully stacked Florida Flamingos team from backups all the way to starters. This is the all-star team, and I think, honestly, the sleeper to possibly win the weird-shaped trophy this year. But we're going to go ahead and take it over to the access panel, and we're going to let them figure out and try to predict who they think is going to end up winning this. There, of course, there's four members of the access panel. I don't know all their names. I just know that they're panelists number 1 through 4, and they usually give me a quick prediction of what they think is going to end up happening. And right now, panelist number 1 says that Florida is going to look silly out there today, and they're going to feel this loss for a while. He's got the Stanford Superstars winning 27-0. That is a harsh loss that he has them losing by. Meanwhile, panelist number 2 says that Florida gets the win in a very, very close matchup of 29-26. They got Florida winning by a field goal. Panelist number 3 says that Michael Carter is going to shut down the offensive line today, and he's probably going to record a couple sacks. He's got Florida winning 37-6. That is a big margin for them to go over in. And then you'd go over to panelist number 4, who says that on paper, these teams are very closely matched, but you have to go with the gut instinct when you go with this type of stuff. He has Florida winning, but the way the margin is listed, he has Florida going over Stanford 44-9. So 3 out of the 4 panelists got Florida winning this game. I honestly believe that this could be anyone's battle in this case, but in my opinion, I would have to agree. I would give this to the Florida Flamingos because I believe that the Flamingos have a very perfectly balanced team, offense and defense-wise. If someone goes down, it's like they never lost a spoke on that wheel to begin with. When another one gets popped right back on there. Folks, we are 7 minutes away from kickoff. It is anticipation building into this arena here tonight. And of course, if you like what you see here today, make sure you hit that follow button on this channel. You subscribe to the YouTube channel. The video on demand goes up immediately after the stream on both here and on Twitch. If you want to watch last night's VOD, you can watch that as well on here. And of course, tomorrow we'll feature another game, same time, 3:30 p.m. pre-show, 4 p.m. kickoff between the Detroit Sweats as they visit the final brand new expansion team, the Miami Vibe, inside of Florida. Florida hosting 2 home games this week with the Flamingos and the Vibe both playing against the Superstars and the Sweats. And of course, Monday, 3:30 p.m. Pre-show, 4 p.m. start time. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, anyone in between, it is 4 o'clock p.m. Eastern Time, and it is time for Game 2 of Week 1 of the Starverse Football League. I'm that cash guy, I'm your host, and tonight's game is the Stanford Superstars against the Florida Flamingos. We're getting ready to get this game going, so let's go on and get down to the field. I'd like to thank everyone that has watched the first game and is going to be enjoying the next few games as we go along these 16 weeks. This is going to be one heck of an incredible matchup between these two teams. Of course, the second ever expansion team added, the Stanford Superstars, are now here. They're going to be taking on a very tough and formidable Florida Flamingos team who is now newly rebranded. So it'll be very interesting to see how both of these teams will go up against one another. It is nice and sunny here in Orlando, Florida. Outside, I don't know why there's a baseball diamond in the middle of this field, but I guess that's what happened when we get one of those low-budget fields to play football in. It's what happens. This is the Starverse League, baby. And our opening kickoff is going to be given to us by Mike Magnum Maxwell, the biggest veteran in the SFL. He's going to kick this bad boy off, and the Superstars are going to return this. That is Felix Fortain, the tight end, going to return this. And he's taken down short of the 30-yard line to kick this game off, and he's going to start it from the 28. Are the Stanford Superstars. And the big story here, quarterback Shane Spain, brand new quarterback. Some people compare him to Brett Favre. He's going to be starting this bad boy off. He's got a young running back in Tayshawn Dawkins. He's also got a few very experienced wide receivers. He's got Chris Knight. And, of course, he's got Casey Quest Wilson and Toby Coleman. That is Toby Coleman, the fullback, going to start things off. And there is already a flag on the play, offsides for Bobby LaFleur. But it doesn't matter. Marcus Jones Jr. is the one that gets the tackle for a loss. And it'll be first and five. Unfortunately, that tackle for a loss is not going to matter for the Flamingos at this moment. Marcus Jones Jr., of course, was a third-round draft pick, I believe, for the Superstars. Tayshawn Dawkins is going to run a couple yards to start this thing off. He's going to get maybe no gain there. And that was a tackle for a loss. That wasn't even a no gain. That was a no-gain tackle there by Bill Goldberg. Goldberg's here, baby, and that is what it's all about. Dawkins got no yards on that run in his very first handoff of his career. He gets another handoff, this time a couple more yards, and he's about 4 yards running in there. He's 3rd and inches just short of that first down, and they are in the red zone. This is a really good field position to start this game off, but we will go ahead and see if they can get the conversion here. Dawkins got 5 yards on that, but it was just short of the first down line. Go! Spain, first pass of his career, hand off to OC Gray, the rookie, touchdown, Stanford Superstars, and he's telling him it's going down. Oh my God, OC Gray, the third string wide receiver for the Superstars, getting the touchdown. Wow. That might be the fastest touchdown we've gotten so far this season. It took almost the entire first quarter for one touchdown to get made. This time it only took 2 minutes. Took about a minute and a half even, less than 2 minutes. OC Gray, one hell of a touchdown there. Shane Spain connecting. And now Fred Stout, who already got the extra point in, is going to be kicking this. What a run from the rookie. David Fowler going to return this kick. Let's see what he can do. Fowler getting out of the way. He stopped just short of the 40, I believe. He's taking out the 32. What a phenomenal catch there. Connection. And if Shane Spain can connect like that for like the rest of this game, I think Stanford's set. That was incredible. However, this is the first handoff for Antonio Stark, the rookie quarterback. It's handed off to Nicholson, the former quarterback. What storytelling. He's short of the first down, but that's a 7-yard pass there for the now tight end. Good golly, Miss Molly. 7-yard pass there made by Stark. 2nd and 3. And a man in motion. I think that's Fowler. That's Gray. Matt Gray. Stopped short of the first down line. That's a tackle there by Ted Lawless for a loss. I told you Ted Lawless would be very dangerous over for the Flamingos. And that is indeed the case here. Or for the Superstars, my apologies, not for the Flamingos. I mean, either way, it's still dangerous for both teams.
Tonight.
That was Eamon Drake in motion. And it is, it's Lawrence Nightingale. Nightingale catches, shoved one defender off, but was taken down. Lawrence Nightingale, the eighth. I don't know why it says seven there. Just can't get enough of his digits. The way he brushed off Masago Watanabe there too. That was awesome. I'll give him that. As Antonio Stark sends Nightingale in motion. Looking for somebody. He's got someone open down the line. It's Matt Gray. And he's short of the first down. Second and one now. This is great offensive football here. This is stab, stab, stab right away from both teams. As I got to say, I didn't expect it to come right out the gate. Just both these teams swinging. But I dig it. I'm appreciating it. It's good football for me. Fowler lined up with somebody. Hand off to Matt Gray. Matt Gray stopped behind the line. Masago Watanabe gets a tackle for a loss there. Watanabe making her first big hit of the season. Watanabe, who was, of course, a former magician, well known for sucker punching the Title Town coach. As it's a third and four now. Stark gets sacked. Wow. Tariq Van Diver with the big hit. Wow. Tariq Van Diver with a big tackle. Almost missed Stark there. Grabbed him by the ankle, stopped him there, and now forces them into a field goal. Well, this should be easy for Maxwell, as it is. 44-yard field goal makes it. It's now 3-7. Stanford. And I'll give them that. Really good defensive strategy to wear them down to get that sack on the end and that sack tackle down to the end and get that big old sack down to the end and get them forcing only a three instead of a six. Fortain's gonna return this. He's stopped behind his own men. He brushes one tackle off. He brushes another one off, but he's hit hard. He's sent backwards back to the 20. To the 25, sorry. This will be the first and 10 from the 25 for them. This handoff to Dawkins. Dawkins rushing one man off, but gets hit hard. Hit hard by Pink Jersey, I believe that was number 94. That's Bill Goldberg. Goldberg, just if he's able to record tackles consistently, he's going to be the defensive MVP of this game, well, potentially for his team. Deshaun Dawkins, out of those three runs, has only run 9 yards. They're doing really good at containing the run game from Stanford here, but the passing game they got to look out for, because that was just so sudden, that pass to Gray. And speaking of Gray, OC Gray catching that, but he's short of the first down, third and two. We got Matt Gray on one side, and you got OC Gray on the other. That's not confusing at all. You see OC Gray, he's got one touchdown, 66 total yards already, only has made two catches. Hand off to Dawkins. Oh my God, I don't know what the heck was going on there, but that was a tackle for a loss by Bobby LaFue. I don't know what happened there. I think there was a lot of miscommunication. They just ran right into each other. That was like a car wreck on I-95. Orton now is going to kick this one off for the first time. And it's handed off to Fowler, who's not going to get anything. He stopped at the 30. They've been doing a really good job at containing Florida's offense here, stopping them from getting anything more than a field goal so far. They've only had the ball once too, so they're really doing good at possessing that ball for long periods of time. Hand off to Matt Gray. Matt Gray finds a spot at the middle, and he is taken down short. I think that is a 6-yard run. It is. It's second and four. With less than 8 minutes left to go here in the first, I gotta say, these games are really impressing me. These teams really have come far from the arena football days. Stark now, hand off to Nicholson. He's got the first down. Jordan Nicholson becoming a receiving weapon now. That's incredible to see. He's caught like two passes now. Stark is 4 for 4. He is batting 1,000 at this moment. I do not want to jinx him. He might be the prodigal son here.
Go!
Stark dips back. It's caught by Nicholson again, who gets a 2-yard catch. Making it 2nd and 8 now. Second and 8 with 6:37 left. Got a man in motion. Let's see what Stark does here.
Sit up.
Stark, oh my God, Stark getting sacked again. Tariq Van Diver with his second, recording his second sack of this game. That is unfortunate for the Flamingos here. Unfortunately, and it brings them only the 3rd and 7, luckily. It's not a 4th down situation again like last time, but still, that is tough. That is tough.
Go.
Stark now with a lot of room he's got to get. He's got a long pass off. It's caught. Lawrence Nightingale. Lawrence Bartleby Nightingale, the 8th, making another big reception here. He's here when it matters. I tell you, Florida's offensive wideouts are the best in the league. We've only seen 4 teams play. And I still stand to that. Matt Gray gets a 3-yard run before he's stopped by a swarm of white jerseys. He's got 7 yards recorded on the 4 rushes. He gets another rush. He gets the first down this time. And he's stopped just short before he can get any more yardage there. And that was Javarian Washington on the tackle for the Stanford Superstars. What are they gonna do here? Stark. He's got Fowler. Fowler with a good sideways pass there. And he stopped short of the first down. 2nd and 1, 9-yard pass there. The David Fowler. Oh, good God, you got Nicholson, who's now added up with Drake, Nightingale, and Fowler. That is a core receiving team right there. Take note of Nightingale in motion. Matt Gray trying to get those extra yards, and he's short. Only able to recruit one. Only able to get 3 feet closer to that line. Stark now. Oh man, I think he was looking for Eamon Drake there. Just was either threw that too short or was just overthrown. Not exactly what happened there. Again, holding Mike Maxwell down to only getting another field goal. So now they're only down by 1. But if they can do this consistently, I think Stanford might actually have this in the bag. Fortain going to return this from the 10. And he's going to get stopped at the 22, it looks like. The 27, sorry, I can't do math. And I gotta say, these two quarterbacks, this might be the story of the game. I thought it was gonna be the wide receivers. The story of the game might be Spain and Stark.
Hey.
And off to Dawkins. he's going to get about 5 yards on that. They're going to mark him short. He's going to get 4 yards on that run. Of course, I want to thank everyone that's been watching and everyone that has watched the previous game before this. Hope you watch the next two games when they come tomorrow and Monday. Airing same time. That's Dawkins, who's got, I think he's got the first down. He's marked short again. The refs just love marking Dawkins short. He's third in inches now. That's Spain. He gets the quarterback sneak in the first down. That's all they needed. That's a real smart move there by Spain. And you see, that's why people say they remind him of Brett Favre. He reminds people of Brett Favre, the way he only runs when it matters. He's got the famous Favre slide down, where he doesn't slide at all.
Go!
And off to Dawkins. Dawkins gonna do a juke, but he's hit hard. And I think that's behind the line. That's Michael Carter. And I was wondering when he was going to come in and be a factor. Big Michael Carter. And that is his first tackle recorded of the game. Tackle for a loss.
Tonight.
Right behind the line. No, Vaughn. Tristan Vaughn. He's going to get hit hard there. And that was only a 1 yard gain there as well. Gotta say, this is good defensive football here from the Flamingos. Spain. He's got a man all the way down there. It's Chris Knight. Chris Knight stopped at the 20. Wow, his first catch of his career. What a reception there for Knight. And Stanford just coming out of the wet work with these long passes when they matter. That's Knight in motion. He sends out Dawkins, however. Dawkins ends up falling. I don't know what the hell happened there, but he did not get that much of a gain, maybe about 4 yards. As we're heading towards the 10-second mark of this game, I think this will be the end of the first quarter. 7-6 Stanford right now. And that'll be the end of the first. 7-6 Stanford. Superstars in the lead here over Florida. As we get ready to start off the second quarter. Hope everyone's been enjoying this so far. I know I have.
Go!
Spain. Spain getting sacked for the first time. Johnny Farmer. John Farm. John Farm. John Farm is here, baby. Johnny Farmer, one hell of a tackle. Oh, man. Ah, yeah, he got a tackle. Spain with another pass. It's picked away nearly. Swatted away by the defender, by the Florida cornerback. I think that was Adonis Mason or Ty Smith that got a hand on it. Stout gets the field goal. That's his first field goal of his career, 36-yarder. It's now 10-6 Stanford. Out with the kick. Hand it off to Fowler. Fowler gonna get speared. And he stopped at the 30. Or short of the 30. He's at the 29. Wow. Just 1 yard short of the 30. Gotta love it. You'll love it. You love to see it. If at any point you want me guys to shut up, I will. I won't. But I will for a second. Matt Gray gonna run. And I think that's a 6-yard run, maybe a 5-yard run there. They're marking 2nd and 5. Minutes only passed here in the second quarter. Last game, I didn't even know the second quarter had happened.
Tonight.
Oh, wait a minute. Spain, wow. Matt Gray didn't even bother. Spain Stark getting hit by Van Diver. Again, that's the third straight sack for Tariq Van Diver. And that is insane. He's got 4 tackles and 3 of them being sacks. He might be the one to look out for. Stark now gets caught by Nightingale. And that's at past midfield at the 50, at the 43. Another big reception for Lawrence. And LBN might just be the guy. Nightingale with those 3 catches has almost gotten 100 yards already. They're about 8 yards short of that. Stark looking for Nightingale again. Could not get it. Stark was looking for Nightingale again on that pass. Could not get the catch. Let's see what happens here. We've had the ball for about 1:46 now. Start the Nicholson. That is a 3rd and 3 situation. Jordan Nicholson getting positive yards every catch. That's kudos to him. And of course, we want you to tune into our game tomorrow, which will be between the Detroit Sweats and the Miami Vibe in the same arena here. Matt Gray. Gonna run, he's short, and that's a 4th down. Tackle for a loss, Tariq Van Diver again. And I'll give Van Diver is one hell of a fucking player. That is incredible.
Hike.
McAfee gonna punt this one off. And the field goal unit's not gonna come out here. That's the first punt of the game. It's by Pat McAfee, the legend. Former Indianapolis Colt, current WWE commentator, host of the Pat McAfee Show. All around great guy. Well, I hope my stream doesn't cut out soon because my lights are flickering. Kayshawn Dawkins gets a 1-yard catch. That was a desperation get rid of it pass. I'm just gonna warn you guys, the wind is blowing pretty hard here. If the storm puts the stream out, I apologize. We will try to get back as fast as possible. I will make sure that the game does not end. Spain. With a catch off by O.C. Gray. O.C. Gray with at the 41-yard line, the 37-yard line. What a catch there from Gray. What a beautiful, beautiful reception there from Gray.
Go.
Dawkins spread off 1 tackle. He gets another one. However, he gets a 6-yard run on that. Kayshawn Dawkins. Dawkins getting the ball again. He gets pushed forward, and I think that's the first down. No, he's short. They're going to mark him short. It's a 3rd and 1 situation now.
Hike.
Bang. Passes to Casey Wilson, and Quest gets his first catch of the game. That's a 1st down. Casey Quest Wilson making his first catch as a superstar. Hand off to Dawkins. Dawkins gonna push this. Dawkins hit hard. Short of the first down. That was Baron Corbin on the tackle. Tayshawn Dawkins with 11 rushing, with 11 rushes for 40 yards.
Tonight.
Not bad for a rookie, but he stopped behind the line. Bill Goldberg with a tackle for a loss. That might be his second tackle for a loss there. Goldberg is doing great here. Gotta say, Florida's defense is starting to pick up Stanford's playbook here for a minute. I think they're stopping them every second they get. Three tackles recorded by Goldberg. Dawkins, spin move. He stopped hard. Big, big hit there. That was by 42 on the Flamingos. 42 on the Flamingos, Marcus Jones Jr. The secondary quarterback, cornerback, defensive back, whatever. The field goal made, and it's good. Fred Stout making a second field goal. And now it's 13-6, Superstars here over Florida. Superstars really got to do something. They have yet to put on a touchdown. They've been held down the field goals. Now they're down by 7. David Fowler got some time to return this. He's stopped at the 25. The 26, they're going to mark him at least. They're generous with this one. Kind of interesting how they keep marking Dawkins short on the Superstars, but they gave Fowler that extra yard. Okay. Not saying ref ball's in play here, but I don't know if I'm allowed to call that. Fowler, big catch there. David Fowler. And he's marked at the 33. What a reception. Big catch there for David Fowler.
Tonight.
41 yards they've gotten so far in this possession with that catch. And that was Matt Gray now. He stopped at the 5. Or just, he stopped, wait, he stopped at, sorry, the 26. I'm not looking at the screen. Second and 3 now. I mean, I was looking at the screen. I just wasn't looking at the numbers. The numbers, Mason. What do they mean? Matt Gray gonna run this again. He's got the first down. Getting the first down there before getting stopped by number 46. On the Superstars. Which, if I can find number 46, that's Tank. That's Tariq Van Diver. All right, Tariq Van Diver's just everywhere today, I guess. Stark gonna run this up the middle. Is he nuts? Oh my lord, he got some yards, but at what cost? Stark with a 5-yard run before getting taken down by Adrian Cohen. By Adrian Cohen of the Flamingos. Stark now. I'm going to hand it to Gray. Gray's going to be short of the first down. And they're going to bring in Umar Muhammad. Who's been one heck of a tank for his team. Muhammad. He makes it all the way to the 5. He's at the first and goal now. Red zone situation for the Flamingos. You know, to this, you know, I know we're supposed to be in Florida, and I know we're in Orlando. But why is there a baseball diamond in the field? Just explain that to me. Explain. No? Okay. Matt Gray gonna run this. He's gonna get a yard, maybe. Maybe no yards. It's a second and goal. It's on the 3-yard line. So we got up just a bit. Didn't look like it did, but it did. You figure it out. It's a second and goal now on the three. Stark with the fake handoff, but he doesn't see the sack. He did not see it. Oh, my God. That's Ray Roberts. Wow. He came out of nowhere. Ray Roberts, the cornerback, wasn't blocking anybody. Went straight for Stark's head. Taking Stark out like Yoda money. Matt Gray going to run this. And he's going to be short. It's going to be fourth and goal, and this might be a field goal situation. Maxwell going to kick this, and it's going to be good. And now it is 13-9. Stanford and Florida here. Here in the second quarter with 2:49 left before we go to halftime. Less than 3 minutes. And I got to say, Stanford's been playing really well here. Maxwell going to kick this bad boy off. It's going to be from the 10. 14. He stopped. He stopped. He can't get around. What is going on? Felix 14. Felix 14 getting stopped at the 30 because he just wants to go and he just gets stuck. Oh, man. Oh, I wish there was replays. That was great. Oh, man, at the 30. Spain to Dawkins. And he's about three short of the first. It'll be second and three on the 37. Everyone push. Almighty push. No, it's like that scene in The Longest Yard where everybody's pushing the entire team. Is that legal? Yeah. Is that a touchdown? Yeah. Go. Dawkins. He gets the first down a little bit more as we reach the 2 minute warning. Tayshawn Dawkins just lacks speed. Other than that, he's fine. It is now first and 10. Spain, he ducks one tackle, but he doesn't duck the other. Michael Carter, and I told you, I called it. Michael Carter recording a sack. And it's a big sack, taken down, no giggity, second and 19. Spain now with the throw. It's incomplete. Not exactly sure who he was looking for there. I knew Michael Carter was going to come into play somehow in this game. And lo and behold, he came into play. Not only that, he came to play. Dawkins getting hit. They call a timeout, Florida. They got two remaining here with 35 seconds. You know what's crazy? They called that timeout and the play clock's still running. The punt team has been called out. Oh, I'm an idiot. That was not the official game clock. I'm looking at the wrong one. Fowler returning that barely. He's at the 25 now. Or the team is at the 25. Gonna be a first and 10 here. Stark immediately. Stark getting sacked right away. Tariq Van Diver has recorded his fourth sack today. And it is now second and 17. by the third baseline. Why is there a baseball diamond?
Take.
It's caught by Nightingale, who takes it at midfield. Timeout called by Florida. 33 seconds left in the half. And when we go to halftime, folks, we're going to take a look at the stats of everything. We're going to take a look at how both of these teams have been doing so far. 33 seconds left here in the second quarter. Stark, a lot of room. He hands off to Nicholson, who gets a yard. And he gets out of bounds, stopping the clock. So it's now 29 seconds left. They've only wasted a few seconds. They got to do something. They got to get a touchdown. They've been trying so hard to get a touchdown this entire game. And only been able to get those three field goals. Stanford's been really good at stopping them in the red zone.
Go!
Stark is giving it to Eamon Drake. Eamon Drake's got the first down. He's out of bounds. 22 seconds left. They're on the 33-yard line now. They're in enemy territory. They got to get something done here. Send a running back in motion. It's given to Hayward. Bodie Hayward. The backup tight end comes in, gets some yardage at the timeout call. They got no timeouts left here. 15 seconds remaining, second and four. They can get another field goal here and just be down by one going into the half. But I don't think that's what they want. They want to be in the lead before halftime. Stark hands off to Nicholson. He's short, but he makes it out. No, he doesn't. They mark him down inside. And that's going to be halftime. They can't get the field goal off in time. Let's take a look, folks. So far in this game, it is 9-13. And you see the quarterback comparison. This is a phenomenal offensive game. This is, very defensive too. I gotta say, I was not expecting Stanford's defense to stop them every time they've been trying to get a touchdown. It's phenomenal. There have been no turnovers at all. Spain's only got one touchdown pass so far. However, it's the running game from both teams, and of course, may I say, it's the defensive game from both teams as well. Let's take a look at the game stats. Right now, of course, the offensive MVP for Florida, Lawrence Bartleby Nightingale VIII, with four catches and 128 yards. He got to 100 yards in his third catch. That shows you how incredible it was, and that was very early in the game. Michael Carter, meanwhile, on the defense, is the monster. He got his first sack of the career. He's got one tackle for a loss, and he's got three tackles to his name. And you want to talk about tackles to their name. Over on Stanford, Tariq Van Diver is the big story, the story that came out of nowhere. He's got four sacks, one tackle for a loss, nine tackles already. And then on the offense, right now, O.C. Gray, who was very explosive in the very beginning of the game. He wasn't really that audible or very vocal or very well seen in the second quarter, but in the first quarter, he made those three catches for 112 yards. One of them, the very first catch of the game, for a touchdown. It was 66 yards. It was amazing. I want to talk about the team leaders. Let's talk about the story between Antonio Stark and Shane Spain here. They have very, very high quarterback ratings. Stark was 4-for-4 very early in the game, and now he's 15-for-17. He's got an 88% percentage on his catch rating. He's gotten 235 yards accrued. No touchdowns just yet. Spain, he's only missed two catches. He's got a 78% percentage. Sorry about that. One touchdown. The run games, just like last week, are a little bit different. Sorry, let me take a drink. The run games are just like last game, yesterday. Very, very different. Matt Gray's run 13 times for 45 yards. He's averaging 3.5 yards a carry. Tayshawn Dawkins has gotten 51 yards. He's averaging about 3.6. But it's like, I mean, they are somewhat similar. However, it seems like Matt Gray, he just seems to get a little bit more yardage every time he gets the ball. Despite the average, he's gotten more first down conversions than Dawkins. They had to rely on Tristan Vaughn a couple times, who's got negative yardage on the stat board. Meanwhile, Umar Muhammad, the one time he's played, he got a first down. Over on the receiving side for Florida, I never thought I'd say this, but Jordan Nicholson is a very phenomenal receiver. He's converted well from the quarterback to tight end position. He's got 6 catches to his name for 29 yards. He's averaging 4 yards a catch. Nightingale is the MVP, of course. 4 catches for 128 yards, but right behind him is O.C. Gray with those 3 catches for 112. They're like neck and neck pretty much. And then you got David Fowler. Those 2 catches, 50 yards. He's averaging 25 yards. He's got yards. And then, of course, you know, on the defense side, it's Tariq Van Diver and Ray Roberts, who have 9 and 10 tackles each. Meanwhile, over in Florida, it's kind of spread even between Corbin, Jones, Carter, Goldberg, and Farmer. So it's going to be really tough to see who's going to go into this battle, who's going to end up being the victor. I'm really hoping that Florida finds some way to get a touchdown this game. They've been very unsuccessful in the red zone. That might be the big detriment and might cost them the game here in the end. With 37 total plays, they've played more plays than Stanford. However, they've gotten less rushing plays. They've played more passing plays. They've gotten way more total yards. They've got in rushing and in passing. But they've also gotten 2 sacks. That's not compared to the 5 sacks Stanford's gotten. Shane Spain's been hit a lot this game. And no turnovers just yet. So we'll go ahead and go into the second half now, folks, as we go ahead and see how the rest of this game is going to turn out. As we begin the second half, of course, Florida will be getting the ball back. Fowler will be returning this. And we hope you tune in for tomorrow's game from the Detroit Sweats against the Miami Vibe. That's the same time, 3 p.m. pre-show, 3:30 p.m. pre-show, 4 p.m. kickoff. Fowler's going to return this to the 21, 22. We're going to begin this. There's a flag on the play. Stark going to get the snap off. It's caught by Nicholson, who's got room. Nicholson, he stopped at the 20, but what's the flag? And the flag's on Matt Bloom of the Florida team. That big throw is going to hold them back just a little bit. It's going to be first and 20. Big 10-yard penalty, but Nicholson, big reception, big pass there. Look at Jordan Nicholson, 6 catches, 29 yards. He's been targeted all 6 times. Greg, a stop behind the line for a loss. Ted Lawless. That's unfortunate. That pass from Nicholson was going to get taken back. It's not going to get caught. It's not going to get recorded, unfortunately. And knocks them back at their own 10. Stark. Hands off to Chiaverini. Darren Chiaverini getting his first catch. 3rd and 11 now. It's a 9-yard catch. A lot of ones on Chiaverini. And a catch there. Fowler got the first down. He's chop blocked. Short of midfield, he's at the 40. Florida showing some life. Maybe had a little bit of a pep talk. Maybe got screamed at by the coach. Stark. That's caught by Nicholson again. And he makes up for it. He's at the 18 now. Jordan Nicholson. Stark now, he's sacked. He's hit by Adrian Cohen. That's a loss. Second and 17 now. Big, big loss there.
Go!
Matt Gray, he's hit behind the line. Another loss by Adrian Cohen. Stark now, all the way back. And it's incomplete. And that's going to be a 4th and 24. And once again, Stanford has held them back from getting another touchdown. It's a 4th and long, too. That's really unfortunate.
Go.
And the field goal is good by Maxwell. 48 yards made. Mike Magnum Maxwell. It's now 13-12. At least they cut the deficit down by one. And now 14 gonna return this. Stanford defense has been putting in work. They indeed have been, Stang. They indeed have been. They're putting in all the work right now. As 14 was able to return that to the 29-yard line. We'll see if Stanford can get another touchdown here. And maybe break this deficit down again. Dawkins. Gonna be at the 35. That's a 5-yard run there. The 33, sorry. You know, it's not me. I feel like they're giving him short. They're shorting him every time. It's not me, is it? It's not just me, is it? Am I noticing this? Am I going crazy? Spain getting sacked. He got his leg caught. John Farm. Another big sack there. Third and 14. I want to talk about defenses that came to play. Florida. Quest Wilson getting the catch. That's a first down. Never mind. That just didn't matter. Quest getting the catch there. What a catch there from Casey Wilson. Bane gonna get hit again. It's fumbled and recovered by Michael Carter. Michael Carter recovering the fumble. And Florida has the ball again. Big fumble there. Big sack on the Spain. Spain's been hit 7 times now. Stark handing it to Fowler. Fowler gets it in before he's taken out. Stark was able to get that in before he was tackled by Ray Roberts outside. Fowler was. Look at that. Stark's only missed 3 passes this whole game. He's got 312 yards passing. No touchdowns just yet. But it's intercepted. The first turnover there for Florida. Joe Peoples on the interception. Joe Peoples, former USC Trojan, former Tennessee Titan. Getting one hell of an interception there. Turnover after turnover. Tayshawn Dawkins stopped behind the line by Farmer. John Farm. John Farm. John Farm. Oh my God. They're just not leaving this area. They're just this one particular area of the field they're just staying in. The announcer curse has indeed struck again. Spain getting hit again! John Farm! John Farm! John Farm at the three-peat! Nerf Johnny Farmer, please! Oh my goodness gravy. It is third and long for the Stanford Superstars. Nickel package out. Dawkins stopped short. And it's going to be fourth down. And the punting unit's going to have to come out here. Or at least we're going to see Pat McAfee again. He's only came out once so far. So Pat McAfee, or not, yeah, Pat McAfee going to punt this one off. I think, or no, my bad, that's Randy Orton. Sorry about that. He's only come out here once or twice. And off by Fowler. Or returned by Fowler, sorry. 37-yard line. Good God, Johnny Farmer just coming out of the wet work. Just coming out of the woodwork, sorry, to give the wet work. I cannot get my words right today. Stark now handing it to Gray. And he gets maybe about three. Yeah, he does. And Bodie Hayward's got a leg injury, the tight end. That's going to take out their second string tight end for Florida for a minute until we can get word on when Hayward's going to return. So that'll bring in Stacey Evans. Stark going to try to run it. I mean, maybe it's giving me, and he only got a couple yards up on that. He only maybe got three, but about did as much as if he would have ran it off the Matt Gray. And no, I'm not going to explain what that noise was. Six minutes left in the third. Gray, he stopped right behind the right before the first long, first down line. It's now fourth and one. Big tackle by Masako Watanabe. And the punt by McAfee is going to go all the way out there. Near the stands. You know, for a rookie quarterback, Stark is doing good. I agree. I agree 100%. I 100% agree. I think Stark is doing phenomenal. He's only missed a few catches other than that interception. Spain's doing pretty good, too, for a rookie, but he keeps getting hit. He needs a better O-line. Dawkins. Going to get, like, a couple feet there, and he stopped short. Of course, like I said, tomorrow's their game between the Sweats and the Vibe. But, of course, Monday will be the game between the Red Lions and the Thieves. Both of these games happening same time as this game. 3 o'clock and then 4 will be a kickoff. Dawkins is going to be a little bit short of the first down there, and it's going to be 3rd and 1. And really, both of these quarterbacks in their first outings, just like how Brian Carter did last night, are really, really showing that they have what it takes to hang with the boys. Brian Carter specifically. And that was incomplete there from Spain. Just couldn't get a hand on it. That was O.C. Gray, who he was looking for, who's been a big player in this. Orton's going to punt this one off now. Fowler going to return this from the 34. And he stopped at the 33. He got that from the 27. And he got it to the 33.
4:26 left here in the third. Stark got somebody. No, looking for Nicholson. Just couldn't get it, though. It's the first drop pass there from Jordan Nicholson. There was a lot of coverage there. There was two people there. Two receivers, two defenders. Not exactly sure who was covering who. Got a bit confused at one point. Start. A lot of room. And no, couldn't make it. Was looking for Nightingale. Third and 10. Matt Gray gonna run this. And he stopped right behind the line by Masko Watanabe. It's fourth and 9. And once again, we're seeing the punt units out. This is a very defensive game. McAfee. Getting a good punt out the 14. He's going to stop. No, he makes it past the 30. Sheds another tackle. And he's finally taken down. Finally taken down short of midfield. Right at the 40, at the 38? Yeah, 38. Yeah. Thought that was the 42 for a minute. Damn it, the numbers are going down. You think, okay, yeah, sorry. You think I'd know that. And like, Spain. He's got Carter, and he's got Knight, sorry. Chris Knight with the catch, but Baron Corbin gonna take him down. That's a loss of yards. It's 3:18, 3:16, what? Left in the third.
Tonight.
Deshaun Dawkins. He's stopped, he's hooked. He had some yards, but he couldn't get out of the way. It's good news that Bodie Hayward's coming back, but I don't know if he's going to be used in this situation. Spin move. He stopped behind for a loss. Johnny Farmer. He saw all those tackles by Van Diver and he was like, nah, I got to catch up to that record. Orton. Going to kick this one off. Fowler going to return this from the 11. And he's gonna get on to the 18. Wow, this has just been back and forth of them just stopping each other. No one's able to get close enough to their respective end zones anymore, and able to pull anything off. It's been nonstop punts so far. Game's not closer than I thought. I agree. Matt Gray maybe gets a couple yards there. And he does. It's 2nd and 8. Gray was taken down by Ray Roberts again. Gray gonna run it. And he's about short again on the first down line. It's 3rd and 3. They gotta convert this first. No one's been able to convert a first down yet. Or convert a third down to a first. They've been very unsuccessful Wolf teams so far. Stark's actually dropped a couple passes, flubbed a couple of passes, as has Spain. Spain got sacked a few times. Stark gonna get hit again! Antonio Stark this time sacked by Ted Lawless. And the veteran with the big hit. And it's a 4th and 10, and once again, Pat McAfee's going to have to come out here. 30 seconds less. Less than 30 left in the third. 14. trying to shed these tackles. He's finally hit at the 40, at the 45, 46. I think 14 is the only tight end. I think that's a kick returner. Super insane. Dawkins. Stop behind the line for a loss. Marcus Jones Jr. on the tackle. In the end of the third, it is 13-12. Stanford 13, Florida 12. Superstars on the in the advantage here, and really the Flamingos have not gotten a single touchdown this entire game. It's been all kicks for them. Stanford's done really good at holding them back, and now both teams are doing phenomenal holding each other back here. Second and 11 now.
Tonight.
Hand off to Dawkins. He takes down one guy, but he's stopped once again by, I believe that was Corbin and Goldberg together collectively. That body rocked him. We are in the nitty gritty with the fourth quarter beginning. Third and six. Can this team successfully convert this field goal is the question. Or convert this first down, sorry. And they won't. It's a sack again. Bill Goldberg. Goldberg with another tackle. Fucking Bill Goldberg. I really need to stop with these will it happens, because they're not happening. I would call a fair catch, but I don't think Fowler's gonna shed that tackle and get taken down to 23 or 22. I just can't get the yardage accurate. Gotta give it to Billy G. He's really hitting the hell out of him. Gray. Gonna run it, and he's gonna get about 5 yards. They really need to make something happen here. Both teams have been unsuccessful at converting the third down so far since the half has started. No one's been able to convert it, get to a first down, really. Fake handoff. Oh, wait a minute. He almost got sacked. Luckily, he threw that off, but threw it into someone who was double covered. I think it was Fowler. Very unsuccessful here. Yeah, Imbutabe and Gray back in the line. High formation, handed off to Matt Gray. Gray is going to be stopped short. And it's fourth and two. Once again, the first down has been failed to be converted into. They've once again failed to convert. Both these teams are just unsuccessful in this half. Defensive football. Trying to maintain this one-point lead. Fortain going to return this. He's gonna shed tackles. He's got a lot of room. Felix Fortain, he's taken to the outside. Wow, okay, never mind. I should just stop saying bad things are gonna happen.
Tonight.
Main. He had a man open down there, but he got the catch! Felix Fortain for the touchdown! That man was triple covered! And he still got it! Let's go! What a touchdown there! And the point after is good. It doinked into the end zone. It doinked into the upright. Sorry, it doinked into the in-betweens. So the extra point is good. And now they're up by six. They're up by eight. Sorry, I can't do math. That might have been the opportunity that Stanford needed. from the 10, and he's taken out the 22. 21. See, God. God dang it. Start. Almost intercepted. That was nearly picked off there. He was looking for Chiaverini. They got five wideouts out. There's a handoff to Matt Gray. Gray went into the receiver position. They should have picked up on that. That's a third and five for them. They got to convert this. They have to convert this. I mean, not technically, because there's still 12 minutes left in the game, but still. Stark getting it off. It's Matt Gray for the first down. He was real lucky there. He was real lucky to get that catch off into the first down. He almost got hit right as he got that off. A little lob pass to Matt Gray. Gray once more. Ooh, he's hitting the knee. Hit hard by Roberts. He's slow to get up, but he's getting back. He's back to his feet. That was that first down they needed. Muhammad now, he comes in. So Muhammad was brought in to play that. He's getting real slow to get up too. They're bringing Matt Gray back in. Gray says he's fine. Gets the first down once again. Matt Gray's coming to play. Matt Gray's coming to life with 10 minutes left in the fourth. Stark. He's got a lot of time. He's got it. Lawrence Bartleby Nightingale, the eighth. Touchdown, Florida! That might have been what they needed. And they're going to go for the two-point conversion. Real smart here. Muhammad! He's behind the line. Joe Peoples crushing it. Now they're down by two. Maybe should have settled for the extra point. Not sure. Less than 10 minutes remain. 14. 14 hopping one man. And he sent to the outside. He was going to keep running, luckily. Is called on Stanford, I believe. I could be wrong, but it looks like it's called on Stanford. Maybe a false start. And Spain, he's got to sit here now. First and 15. He's stopped behind the lines. Dawkins is. Brock Lesnar making his first appearance on the field, making a big tackle for a loss. I completely forgot they had Brock Lesnar on the D-line. Holy smokes. Talk about a surprise. Talk about a freaking surprise. Brock Lesnar just showed up. Spain hands it to Fortane. He's going to run up the sideline, but he's stopped behind the line. Bobby. And that hit from the Florida defender, that was number 31. I'll have to take a look and see what that was. That was Brad Jonas, the Dimeback. Spain gonna hand this off. It's Fortane! Felix Fortane! And no one's gonna catch him! Touchdown, Superstars! Felix Fortane making his second touchdown. And now he's about to make this an 9-point game. And no, it doinked! It doinked! Fred Stout! You son of a bitch! Put your motherfucking head back down! Fred Stout! He doinked it! He doinked it! It's an 8-point game still. Fowler stopped at the 26, at the 27. I can't believe it. I would rather have Mike Magnum Maxwell kick another 3-pointer. Oh my God. Stark has to make something happen here. He's going to quarterback sneak it. He's running through people. Look at him. He said, I'm going to do it myself. 8-yard run. Way to go, Fred. That had the worst. That had to be the worst kick I've ever seen. Yeah. Matt Gray going to run it, and he's going to be short of the first down. Gonna get a 1-yard gain, 3rd and inches. Sorry. 2 inches. Or 2 yards. Stark now handing off to Fowler. Fowler's a flag on the play, though. Let's see what's gonna happen here. This could be positive yards or it's coming back. It's a call on Florida, so it's gonna come back. It's 3rd and 10. Oh, and it's going to hurt. That's going to hurt. That was a flag on the offense. On Brian Craig, the offensive lineman. Hike. Matt Gray going to run this. And they're going to be short. 4th and 7. And the punt unit's going to have to come out once more here. 6:34 left here in the fourth. Those back-to-back touchdowns from Felix Fortane really left an effect on this game. Fortane going to return this one. He sheds a tackle once again. Fortane going to run the sidelines. Fortane shutting a tackle. He's forced out of bounds. Wow, someone's got to stop him. Someone's got to stop Felix Fortane. Someone's really got to stop him because Fortane just really ran that bad boy all the way down nearly to the red zone. He technically, they are at field goal range. Hike. To make this an 11-point game, no matter what, Dawkins going to shed a tackle, but damn, he's hit hard by more jerseys. Pink jersey attack there. That was Bill Goldberg on the tackle. Man, that's messed up. You got Goldberg and Brock on the team. You're still losing. And Michael Carter. I'm not going to roast the team, actually. They're doing really well. It's just that was really unfortunate, those two touchdowns. Dawkins, he's got blockers, but he's not enough for the first down. 3rd and 3, and at most, they can set up a 3-pointer here and get that 11-point lead, which will really be a big hangnail in the hand of Florida. I don't know, man. I was trying to come up with some type of allegory, you know, simile, metaphor. Almost intercepted. That was almost picked off. That's pretty scary. Maybe watch who you're trying to throw to. And they're going to go for the three. Stout, don't doink this one. He doesn't. That one's good. It's now an 11-point game. It's going to be 29-18. Stanford over the Superstars over the Flamingos right now with 5 minutes left in the fourth. In these 5 minutes, Florida needs two touchdowns at most. Fowler going to return this. He stopped short again, this time at the 25, 26. Damn it, you're just never going to let me win, are you, computer? Thank you. This is insane. The cat is making a cameo. Matt Gray going to run up a couple yards there. It's two. It's second and three now. Good, Fred, but I'm still waiting on the parking lot for you. Out in the parking lot for you. Let's see if they can get this first down here. It's really crucial. 4.5 minutes left. Star canning it off to Gray. Gray going to shed a tackle, but he's hit behind the line. Watanabe with another hit tackle for a loss there. Trying to climb up this thing and he doesn't know how to climb a thing correctly. It is now third down. They got it. Bodie Hayward's got it. He's got to turn around. He's got blockers. Bodie Hayward out of bounds. The Chase U alumnus getting the first down. What a block there from his co-tight end. I think that was Jordan Nicholson that saved his ass. And Bodie Hayward. Good golly.
Tonight.
Wait a minute. Almost a touchdown pass. That lob pass to Fowler didn't make it. It's second and 10. 3.5 minutes here. They cannot get antsy. I need to stop trying to drill through the middle like that. I mean, you try to because you're a tank. You're a tank, Matthew.
Tonight.
It's caught by Hayward. And the flag on the play. It's this time it's back. It's on Stanford this time. So they're going to get the second down. Second and five.
Tonight.
Gray going to try to run it. He sheds a tackle and gets about 3 yards. A third and three now, or 2 yards, sorry. Look at the butt, cat. It is now third and three. 3:04 left here in the fourth. Florida really needs to make a play here. Stark's got room. He's got Nicholson. I think he got the first down. He did. First and 10. The ref's going to mark his 1 foot in.